Hello everybody, today we are going to talk about supplies. Supplies are the most essential part of Star Sector. Credits also come into play for buying various items, ships, weapons and so on, but supplies are the most important thing. How many supplies you can have on board will determine how large of a fleet you can have. Currently the fleet limit is 30, although I might be mistaken. And every ship takes needs a certain number of supplies per day to function correctly. Now this is taken out of your total supply cost every day, and the more ships you have, the more supplies you will need to maintain the fleet. Now, if we take a look at the fleet tab, you can see all your ships or my ships or whatever. You probably have already a couple of ships. You can easily check how much supplies a ship is using. Let us see where it's exactly. Maintenance supplies per month. Every ship has this. The capital ships cost more every day, and our ships cost less. The supplies are here calculated per month, so this means that per day you're going to need 1.2 supplies per day. This is in the best case scenario. You have to remember that supplies can be spent without you actually wanting to spend supplies, because in addition for the supplies for the fleet to take supplies every day in order to function, you will also take damage if you enter a nebula or something that damages your fleet. You will use more supplies to repair your ships. In case you enter a battle, you will need to spend some supplies to be able to deploy some ships. And after, even if you have one, you will most likely not recuperate the these supplies. Once you got to a point like you're having 10-15 ships, you really should think of investing in large cargo ships, because these tend to carry a lot more supplies and other cargo. These two, I don't know if you will get them in the vanilla, because I think that these two are from the Tiandong. But if you from the Tiandong mod, but if you download the Tiandong mod, make sure whenever you see one of these ships, buy it. There's a massive cargo hold. You can even expand it further, and can increase its burn field. Now, once you start off a new game, you won't have a lot of supplies. But once you start leveling up, you can limit how much supplies your fleet needs every day. Ignore the name. You're looking for fleet logistics. You will see on the second level, negative 25% prius for maintenance. This is extremely, extremely good. Basically, instead of spending 100 supplies for maintenance, for I don't know number of ships, you will spend only 75. You should get this upgrade as early as possible, because it will cost you a lot less supplies. So you will save up a lot more supplies. Supplies are used for a lot of things. For example, for maintenance, which you can see here, negative 21 per day. For combat readiness. So for example, every ship needs to have a combat readiness, a minimum combat readiness, which you will see in a small bar here, named CR. That's the combat readiness. If it's below the minimum level, The ship will damage or will malfunction during the battle. Ah, here it is. Combat readiness. I'm too blind to see. Once it's lower than 25, maybe 30%, your ship will automatically start getting damage. Randomized damage, like damage to the engines, missiles not firing, or something like that. So always aim to have the maximum CR for every ship. In addition to this, once you enter a battle, you will have to deploy a ship, which will also cost you supplies. The more ships you deploy, the more supplies you will need. In addition to this, how large the ships actually are will also determine how many supplies you need to deploy them. Once you are at the point where you want to make colonies, you have to know that even colonies cost money. I think it's around 200 supplies, and even after you have set up the colony, you should give the colony some supplies in order to increase the population growth. In addition to this, you will also use supplies for survey ships. Survey ships are these weird looking ships, and they will reduce the cost of supplies for surveying a planet. So every time you survey a planet, you need a set amount of supplies to do it. So if you don't have a large fleet and you don't have any cargo ships, don't go out and start surveying planets, because you will survey 2-3 ships, and from there on you have to go back. Wait until you have at least 2 or 3 big cargo ships and build your full tankers. Although these are the largest ones, you probably should go for the medium ones if you're early to mid game. The good point about the surveying ships is that you can hit them with salvage gantry. It reduces the amount of supplies needed to survey a planet. In addition to this, how many survey ships you also have will determine how effective will the surveying ship be for salvaging, which basically means the more survey ships you have, the more things you will be able to salvage, including supplies. Okay. In case you go over the cargo limit, you can see that my cargo limit is 14,668. Currently, I have 6,800 cargo inside. If I would have around 15,000 cargo, then you will start using a lot more supplies per day. So if you go to a bar, and let's see if I can find a mission. This is the mission which I was talking about. It's basically a supply run, and you will see that she needs 3,700 units of food to be delivered. Now, I have plenty of additional cargo space to handle this, but let's say this would be 30,000 instead of 3,000. I could take it even if I don't have the cargo space, but the problem is that I will use a lot more supplies, and by a lot more I would say that you can see that my fleet is only using 21 supplies per day, and if I would accept 30,000 cargo, I would probably use 50 supplies per day. Now, let's see how you can make supplies. Yeah, you can buy them from the market. This is fairly simple. Let's where I have. Excuse me, I haven't been on this system for a time. Passive. I think I'm missing something. Here, the obvious. Okay, whatever. You can basically buy supplies from the market. Supplies are not that expensive to buy. You can buy them both from the black market and from the normal market. If you want to have a high standing with a faction, you should buy supplies from the normal market and not from the black market. Because if you buy supplies from the black market, you will get a penalty. Yeah. Although it will be a rather small penalty. Now, if you are short on cash and you decide to buy supplies from the black market, make sure that you do not have any illegal things on board. Because if a patrol fleet comes and checks your inventory, it will clearly see that you have some illegal stuff, and they will confiscate that. You will get also a penalty. In addition to buying the supplies from the market, you also can do the supply runs, which you can find the bar. Like that called not to the certain person, and you make a supply run. Hey, just make sure to calculate how much fuel and how much supplies you would actually need for the supply run. Another good way to get more supplies is by salvaging. This is why it's extremely important to have a couple of salvage fleets in your fleet. I usually go with 3. Some people go with 5. That depends on you and how you outfit your entire fleet. You should always salvage after every battle, because you will a lot of times you will recuperate a lot of supplies that way. Another good way to supplies by building colonies. As you can see on this sector, I do have 3 planets which I have conquered on other faction. This really depends where you set up your colonies. The problem with colonies for relying only on colonies for supplies is that it will take some time that until the colonies produce enough supplies. The colonies you can set to stockpile certain items. I mean, all items. Sorry about that. Let me check it. Okay, so here you can see that what is stockpiled in my colony. Stockpiles and storage are two different things. You should go to the colony and use stockpiles during shortages. Make sure that this is checked so the colony can use it. The resources stockpile, the colony will use this in case of an emergency. Although as you can see, I have 6,000 supplies here. I can take this out. The problem is that I have to pay it at the end of the month. So if you're short on cash, if your colony makes a lot of supplies, you will still have to pay. But once you set up a couple of planets, colonies, this shouldn't be really an issue. Another thing, you can place supplies in storage, although it's just only for a backup plan. Another way to make supplies is by scuttling ships. This is simply dismantling, disassembling ships. The scuttle ships, the mothball function, and this is the scuttle. The scuttle, as you can see, will give me 210 supplies, 200 10 fuel and 52 heavy machine. Now, this only you should do only this piece of an emergency. Because this ship is extremely expensive. For smaller ships, you will get even less supplies. So if you're at the edge that you run out of supplies and you won't reach your destination without most of your fleet getting damaged, you should probably sacrifice a couple of your least valuable ships. In addition to this, you can also, after a battle, once you start salvaging and another ship, you capture another ship, you can cut it, although not needed. Now, one good thing to keep in mind that you can save a lot of supplies if you mothball ships. Keep in mind that once you mothball a ship, it will be like a ship with a skeleton crew. So it will be barely functioning. If it's a cargo ship, for example, you won't be able to use its cargo. If it's a combat ship, you won't be able to use it in combat. And when you mothball it, you will see that the combat readiness will drop off. And if you keep it like that, it will reset. You should probably do mothball your ships fairly rarely. Most importantly, if you capture a big ship and you do not have the supplies to keep it up, just mothball it. Keep in mind that mothballing ships will save you some supplies, but the problem is that you cannot traverse jump, and you cannot deploy them into battle, even as you have to wait a certain amount of time until its combat readiness goes up. So I hope I told you everything I know about supplies, and was clear and you understood it. Thank you very much for watching, and see you later.